Hey everyone, this is my reaction to the fifth episode of Kawaii Kenba Hentai Demo Skini Natte Kuremasuka. And last episode, our protagonist, Mr. Cake, he kind of figured out some stuff about Nanjo. Stuff that he may have preferred not to figure out. But as we know, what has been learned cannot be unlearned, and good example of that. So yeah, now that we've kind of got some insight into pretty much all of our main girls and stuff, I guess let's just see where the show goes from here. 3, 2, 1. But Karakawa Animation. And then the actual anime. Yeah, Anna Fujoshi. Oh yeah, there is also that. Looks like somebody like peeking around a door or something took it. I didn't know we still had that. That reasonable assumption. Anyway, if they want to talk to us, they can't just ask like a normal human being in this show, so. Gotta blackmail them in here. So, place is a little bit unsettling. Okay, that's not good. You'd never want to hear a door close behind you like that. Hello? You're cute. You're not gonna kill me, are you? Or worse, you never know with this show. But anyway, who are you? I just love the way that Yuika is like sneaking up on him, like going for her prey. They just look away. Yeah, there she is. That's the girl from that locked him in there. So she seemed like the shy type, although, you know, Yuika kind of did too, but, I don't know, I guess we'll see. Whew. Yeah, I'll just close that up real quick. Okay. Shoto Club. I'm well aware there was an anime kind of about it, or pretended to be about it, a couple seasons ago. Oh! I mean, I was kind of expecting that after you said Bunny Girl, but still, wow, she looks good in that. Yeah, I think we all do. Can we get, like, a full body shot, or... There we go, she's even hopping around like a bunny. Oh god, my heart. Oh god, can we take her home? Now that's not even an anime I would watch. The day my kohai became a bunny girl. That's way better than Bunny Girl Senpai. Bunny Girl Kohai, the prequel we needed. She is still at it. I can't focus on the subs. But yeah, I guess it is Yuika. At first I thought it was going to be the other girl, but then we got a better shot of her. Sounds like a plan. Indeed. I mean, none of you should criticize other people's personalities. That is attention. Oh. Shooting electricity. Yeah, don't you follow the logic? She looks like she's 5 times bigger than her in that shot. Yes. Add that peon peon. I don't know what's happening anymore, just time to around for the ride. She should, but wow, the compensation. Guess that just kind of worked out. Was interesting. That's about right. Course you do. Don't drop that. Yeah, I don't need to hear more of that. Yeah, I'm good. Yeah, can we read this later, like off screen? It's just so lewd, isn't it? Okay, somebody take this from her before she hurts herself. Yes, I encourage such things. Oh, well, that didn't work. I think I'd rather Friendship Blossom from Yuri books, but that's just me. Okay, so we're all on the same page then. I know, right? Like, no matter what you pick, you're pretty much covered. That was your phone, right? Well, we can't have that. Really? We're gonna do that? Okay. Well, all is right with the world now. Okay, so we're finally gonna get a follow-up to this. What do you want? That's what I'm curious about. I'm sure you're some kind of deranged pervert, so just let us have it. Well, you're not the only one, don't worry. She really is. I doubt it. Oh, okay, is there a follow-up to this? To, Damn. No hesitation there. You don't have to, but just thought you were okay. Oh. Oh no. Oh no. Is she So why are you going after him then? Do you think he's a rival? Then you gotta kill him or? Oh, Tori. A bunny, you say? Yeah, that's pretty clear. Like, yeah. Really handle his own love situation. Unfortunately, I'm able to blackmail you, so it all kind of works out. I guess so. Oh, wow. Are you serious? Wow, okay. I don't think this show is deep at all, honestly, but. I don't know. How much reputation does he have left right now? How kind of him. That's all it really takes, you know, to get anime girl to love you, so. Yes. Yeah, you seem like you're his type, so I don't see the problem. Exactly what I said. Like, I just confess to him, it'd probably work out. And what's the issue? I do want to point out that Cake was also willing to marry her at first glance, so he's more similar than he'd think. Okay. Older than she looks. But is that a deal breaker? I guess it depends on the person, but it wouldn't be for me. Yeah. That's a senpai color. Never really realized that myself, but I see, yeah, that's certainly blue, but let's look at it a little bit longer to make sure, just to confirm. She looks kinda like Sagiri at certain angles. Well, we can all just keep it a secret, just to get a different color skirt. Oh, this girl. Well, I don't know. If the age is a problem, I don't know how you would fix that. Unless you lie to him. Don't be tipping your hat. Ooh. Of course. You see it, you gotta get it. Sudden flashback. No use crying over spilled ice cream. They'll probably give you his because he's a good Onii-chan. See what I tell you. Yeah, making you happy is more valuable than just a little ice cream. Very cliche, but nice little story. Let's not talk crazy. Yeah, I think so as well. Can't just quit the family. Children, get out of the shot. Always ice cream as gratitude. You say that now. Uniform change day. A weird way to translate it, but yeah, when you switch uniforms, I know what they're talking about. But so yeah, this is obviously gonna tie back to, well, what's her face? Very cute, yeah. I like it. Thank you for saving my life with your uniform. So, wow, she looks amazing like that. That. So yeah, I guess the plan is just to hide the bow. Because I think that's what the sister said the difference was. Super effective. Working so far. Gotta hide that ribbon. He'll eventually find out her actual age, but yeah, if we can get him to like her before that point, then it should work out. No, I love this outfit. Don't make me take it off. A form of sunscreen. Well, I mean, it just sort of happened, you know? Well, that's not true. Yeah, wait for it to go horrible. Gotta be weird for her to call him senpai. Yeah, you know. Can we talk online later? It's just so small. I'm sure Akiyama liked it as well, because he doesn't know the truth. Freaking bunny ears on the phone. Didn't notice that before. Well, so far it's been going fine, so. I love you. Well, it's probably somebody you already met, to just. And it's not, then maybe they know you're surrounded by perverts and doesn't want to get close to you until it's dealt with. Yeah, he really helped. He's a great Cupid. We're actually telling her the whole thing, are we? Immaculate. Yeah, some. Yeah, that's the twist. Unfortunately. I don't know if I would trust this girl that blackmailed us with a secret like that, but okay. Yeah, you shouldn't rule it out. Definitely widens the field a bit. I gotta just slip those on to every girl until you see one that fits. Like, hey, have you seen these panties? The... Oh, okay. I guess we're moving on. Don't ask for the impossible. Oh, I was looking at that, Keiki. Guess I'll have to rewind later. It's a bit more important than your little mystery, Keiki, but I guess I just have to go with the ride. She's carrying a lot of papers. Is she gonna drop them and we'll have to help? And is that Ram? Is that Ram? Yeah, we're probably gonna have to help here, aren't we? Yeah, she's gonna fall. This is not safe at all. But luckily, he's here to save the day. Oh, ow. That sounded painful. Ow, they really did go all the way down. Well, yeah, I bet. That's a great position to have landed in. I mean, you don't have to, there's no hurry. Take your time. Are you afraid of something poking you, or? It's quite bold. Wow, he lucked out with this scene, didn't he? I mean, some protagonists would get slapped in that position, and yet she's like, no, this is good. Let's stay here. Let's stay like this a while. So that was interesting. Basically, I introduced the junior girls this episode. Not that I remember either of their names, but. Episode actually felt kind of short. I was actually kind of confused earlier in the episode because I thought the other girls like Nanjo and Yuiga had already joined the club. I don't know, I just kind of assumed, I guess, but apparently not. Apparently they didn't do that until this episode. That's why Yuiga had dressed like a bunny girl. Bunny girl Kohai. I want to believe that's some kind of Spinning Girl Senpai reference. Open. That was our first line of our preview. Okay. Cheap buy, best hope buy. I guess so. But, yeah. That was the fifth episode of Kawaii Kenobi Hentai Demo Skini Natte Kuremasuka. And this episode. The biggest thing, aside from, of course, most of the girls, I guess, joining the club. Which involved Yuiga wearing a bunny suit, which was top tier. The fact that she was not only wearing the bunny suit, which looked great on her, by the way, but also popping around. That was the real meat of it. Like, that was what made it special. Of course, the pyon pyons she said out loud was nice as well, but I could have taken or left that. But the topping around, that's what really sold it for me. So that was great. We didn't get that with Bunny Girls, but I don't think. I was a little annoyed because we said at the very beginning we saw went to the astronomy club and all that, and then we just stopped that for what felt like 7 minutes at least, and then eventually went back to it. That bugged me a little bit. But you know, the show's always kind of had weird pacing issues, but you know, it's whatever. But Yuika reading the Yuika, not Yuika, that's a different character. Yuika reading the I might have called it that before, but I'm not sure. Anyway, Yuika reading Nanjo's stuff, that was a little bit amusing. Probably shouldn't be reading such things, honestly. But does it say the new girl's name around here? Okay, here it is. Koharu. I'll call her Koharu. Because, well, I like the name Koharu for one thing. But anyway, Koharu. So she blackmails him to go into the club room because that's how anyone gets things done in this show. There's a blackmailer, spineless protagonist here. And he goes, of course. And she locks him up in there. His initial assumption was if was her being in love with him, which, to be fair, is a very reasonable assumption because it's happened a lot. This is a harem anime. Still working on the Cinderella situation and having all these perverts attached to him, so it's a reasonable assumption. So, but no, he's just like, okay, I'll marry you. And then she's like, what? No, it's why do I have to marry you? It's not, no, it's not what I was getting at all. It's your friend. That's Akiyama. That's the one I like. Don't be silly, Yuika. Who do you think you're? Wow, names today. Cake. Who do you think you are? But anyway, it is interesting though because he makes comments about how she is totally Akiyama's type. Because of her physical appearance, and yet he was so willing to jump on marrying her, so. And it kind of might be a bit more similar to Akiyama than he may realize. But that's kind of what that tells me. But anyway, yeah, she wanted his help to get together with him. So. But initially, it's like he was like, yeah, well, I don't see the problem. You're like, you're totally his type. Like, what's the issue? Just go confess to him. And then we find out that she is older than she looks. She is a third year, so. I guess that's a deal breaker for Akiyama. I'm not sure why. Age is just a number, especially when your ages are that close. I mean, if she still looks like your preference, I don't really get the issue there. But, you know, different people have different ideas and that sort of thing, so fair enough. But I do think the strategy we've incorporated here is the best one we can do. We just keep her age a secret, and we do that by covering up the bow, because luckily we switched to our summer uniforms, or winter, one of the two. We switched to the other one. And that means the skirts are now all the same color, I guess, and the bow is a different color is a difference. I guess that's how it works. In which case, we just have to cover the bow, which is why she wears the hoodie and all that. But yeah, that's a little bit hot to do that, but I guess it works, you know. Assuming you're allowed to do that at school, but I don't know. Japanese high schools are usually pretty strict, so I don't know if they would let you just wear a hoodie at school, especially in summer when there when you really would be no need for it. But I don't know. As long as there's no issues with that, this is a pretty good strategy. Just hide her age for a while and wait for him to the attachment to really get going, you know, get to have known her for a while, to the point where it's more than a superficial attraction. And then when he finds out, like, oh, you're older than I thought. Well, I guess that's no big deal. I mean, I like you and you like me and we have fun together. I guess it's fine. So yeah, the current strategy we're working with, I think is fine. So as long as we don't run into any hiccups, it should be good. But since this is anime where things have to be kept interesting, there probably will be some issue going forward. I mean, a little bit of stuff with the little sister, you know, a bit of a flashback where he helped her out and current timeline where he helps her out with the bags and stuff. And then, well, he had a talk with Koharu about the Cinderella thing, and he actually told her pretty much everything, which is surprising because he actually told her more than he told Shoma, so kind of a big deal. But she seems like a fairly smart girl, so she can help out. She did give her thoughts on it, you know, about how there could be an extra candidate to not be too narrow-minded to think that these are the only ones. And we went back to the club room where we found Yuika wearing a catgirl outfit, which, you know, was amazing. Nice little pan up and down of it. But there was a lot of talking, so I didn't quite read all of it, but it doesn't really matter. He just runs away. Like, I don't know why he just left. Like, why? Why? Like, couldn't you at least left the camera there as Yuika? Or why do I keep calling him that? While Cake runs away, you know? But no, apparently we had to follow him on his journey through the halls. And he actually ran into a girl Might say her name here as well. Well, he says vice chairman, doesn't actually say a name. But, of course, as soon as I saw her carrying a big stack of papers going downstairs, it was kind of obvious where this was going. But, yeah, good thing he was there, otherwise that fall may have done a lot more damage. How did that paper even do that? Like, it just, there shouldn't be any wind in there. It just straight up went upwards and down, like it was some supernatural thing, but I'm sure it wasn't. And then it just happened to land right where her foot was going and slipped, and it just was all horrible. But luckily, our protagonist saved the day. And then they landed at the bottom of the stairs, where she just kind of insisted on staying in that position. But, I'm not really sure exactly why. Was she just, like, sniffing him? It kind of seemed like that what she was doing. She says, this is, could this be... Not quite sure what she's getting at there. I mean, it doesn't look like she's touching anything in particular from the shots. So, I don't know what she's talking about there. It's like, is this the... What does she mean? Is this the warmth of a boy? Is this the erection of a boy? Like, what is she even... I can't quite tell what she's trying to get at there. But I guess I'll find out next episode. That she just had a crush on him before, and as a result, being put into this wonderful position, he just got a little bit too excited and just doesn't want it to end. I don't know. But, we'll find out. Anyway, yeah, I'd say it was a decent episode. We got Bunny Girl Kohai. We got our, fake Kohai. You know? So, yeah, I definitely like Kohaku, though. She's pretty great. I mean, I can't say blackmailing someone and get what you want is a very, very attractive quality in a person. But aside from that, I do like her. Especially that bit when she was like fluttering her skirt around. It was like, oh, maybe I shouldn't do this. I guess this is a bit indecent. That was a bit of, that was a nice little scene as well. But anyway, yeah, I'd say it was a good episode. Thank you for watching, and a special thanks to Snoki for supporting the channel. If you enjoyed this video, I hope you consider clicking the like button and leaving a comment, because that's a great and easy way to let me know that people want more. If you want to do something big to help the channel, you can support me on Patreon and get nice benefits like early access to certain videos. See you next time.